This video was made possible by EA Game Changers. What is up, my little sugar buggers? Welcome back to the channel for a brand new Stuff Pack review. So today, you guys, we are going to be taking a sneak peek at The Sims 4 Moschino stuff, and I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous. You literally have no freaking idea. I have not looked at any of these items. I've barely even followed the progression of the pack itself. I did, however, look at the trailer, and I will tell you this. I did indeed like it. I loved the trailer. It was super hip, edgy. It was super relevant. Everything about it was absolutely incredible. I really loved the way that they filmed that trailer, to be 100% honest. And so if that is any inclination of what is inside this pack, I honestly don't think I'm gonna be that disappointed. However, okay, I am still nervous. I am still scared. I am still hesitant. I am still all those things. But I guess we'll have to go through the motions of the ocean, and at the end, we will find out together. So let's go ahead and read these little blurbits here that tell us a little bit about the pack. Moschino and The Sims. Show your love for fashion by dressing your Sims in the latest capsule collection inspired by The Sims, or choose clothing styles from iconic Moschino collection. Join a flashy career. As a freelance fashion photographer, your Sim will grow their career with fabulous opportunities. Learn how to curate a collection and select the perfect subject to shoot. Then find the right poses to accentuate the bold, stylized looks. Have a studio session. Bring your own studio to life, where the spotlight is on and so is the pressure. Decorated with pictures, new furniture, and decor, and personalized touches for an inspiring space to photograph your muse. Okay, literally, I'm not even lying, but there is an actual mosquito floating around. Before we head into create a Sim, I do kind of want to go over these images with you guys really quick. So the first thing that stands out to me is 100% the clothing. It is super duper trendy, very fashion forward, very edgy, and I like it. I think it looks really nice. It's very vibrant too, which is kind of cool. Now this sweatshirt looks like something we've already had before. I'm not 100% sure. I do notice a few new hairstyles and those industrial loft windows that everybody is buzzing about. Those are really cool too. Love the mirror, the new lighting, even the photography equipment. That seems really cool. Now I do know we have this with Get to Work, but I feel like this one is a little more sleek, a little more clean looking, and I'm really curious to see how these items function in game. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump into CAS. Not really sure if I've mentioned this or not, but in case you guys were curious as to who the hell Moschino is, it is actually a famous Italian designer, and you are going to see Moschino literally on every single one of these clothing pieces. So diving in to the hairstyles, we've got two. So the first one here is a more sleek, kind of like slippery wet type of hair. It literally looks like this one went heavy-handed with the hair gel, but I like it. I love these types of styles. It's pretty simple. It's not too crazy. It's not too out there. It definitely will allow your Sims' clothing to kind of do all of the talking. So that is what it looks like. And of course, it comes in all of the traditional colors. Would be pretty boss, I'm not gonna lie, to get this in like an ombre color. And so that is the first hair. The second one is interesting, especially for like male. I know a lot of men have very long, gorgeous, beautiful hair. That's not what I'm saying. But the way that this one looks in particular, it's a little different. It is a little different. I'm not sure how I feel about this one, but you know, I can definitely envision it looking amazing on the females. Now there is one more hair, you guys, that comes from this pack, but it's actually filtered or categorized under the females. And I think personally, this looks even more amazing on the males. Like this should have definitely been a male hairstyle too, because I think honestly, I like it better. It's super duper cool. So that's another little hair. And then this one was another female hair that we got. I mean, you know, some people might like it for a male, and that's fine. But this one, definitely, it must be a misstep, because this is absolutely perfect for the males. So I'm going to actually leave this one on Christian because I like it that much. Now we're going to go and dive into the tops. We get four. The first one we get is a very simple graphic tee with the freezer buddy repping his Moschino fit, and that is literally it. Now And we also get a Llamacorn, and I think it just comes in a bunch of different swatches, and that is pretty much it. Now, this is actually modeled after real-life apparel that Moschino and The Sims collabed on. I actually really wanted the earrings, and I'm super-duper excited to know that they're in this pack, which I'll show you guys in just a second. So we get a bomber jacket, and the front, it has, like, the Moschino logo crest or some type of logo, but in the back, there's the branding. It looks like it's kind of off-center a little bit, but that might just be my eyes. I really like this one a lot. I love these types of jackets, and the detail is so on par. Comes in a bunch of colors. These color swatches are pretty much thorough throughout, so you'll notice a lot of these items kind of fit this very same a typical color palette. And so this next jacket, or it's actually a sweater, it's like a crew neck sweater. It's kind of like the cable knit type of material. These are actually peace signs, which I didn't realize what they were at first, and then on closer inspection I'm like, oh my god, these are peace signs. And I actually really like them a lot. It kind of reminded me of the City Living sweater that we got not that long ago, obviously whenever City Living came out. It's like 2 years ago, and at first I was like, oh no they did not, but then I realized, no, these are peace signs, and it's completely different. So we also got a couple with just this little teddy bear patch. Comes in gray, green, and blue. Now, this moto jacket is everything. Now, this first swatch is a little crazy and chaotic, but I wouldn't expect anything less from a pack of this type. This second one is seriously my everything. This jacket is like probably hands down my favorite item from this pack. Like, this jacket is just, oh, it's beautiful. I love it. They did such a great job with this. Would have loved more than two swatches. Now, that's my biggest gripe so far. These swatches are kind of limited. And you'll see what I mean kind of when we get deeper into the pack. So the cool thing is that the top actually has matching bottoms. So you could either go and match it with the first watch, or you can just go and do a full-on leather ensemble head to toe. We've also got some really cool joggers that match the bombers. And these are really interchangeable. Like, you can mix and match these in so many different, like, variations, and they will go together seamlessly. So we have one full body outfit, which I actually am not so sure how I feel about it. Now, it's really cool. It's really out there. It's very bold. Would have loved to, again, been able to kind of like warm up to this item with more swatches, because as it sits, it really doesn't have very much like functionality, at least for me personally. Now, I get it though. It's probably for the new career, but at the same time, definitely would have loved a couple other variants, you know? You know what I mean? You know what I mean. So last but not least, we do actually have a pair of what appears to be some very shiny leather, vinyl, pleather. I don't even know what type of boots, but these things are amazing. Check out the sheen. These are frickin' everything. I even like the little pull tab in the back. So overall, I'm very, very pleased with the items. Again, it is a stuff pack, so of course we are going to be limited, but there are so many things that you can do. Like I said earlier, the only downfall, in my personal opinion, is just the lack of swatches on some items, but not all. So here we are with Amiko. She's actually from the Maxis Gallery. We have three hairs to share with you. The first one that you guys saw earlier, like I said, I just feel like with the frame of the females, this hair definitely fits a little bit better. It's very like Kim K, you know? And I know so many people are going to probably like yak all over me for even saying that, but it is. It's very high fashion, and I love these types of hairstyles. They're very sophisticated looking, at least in my personal opinion. So I definitely love that on the females. Here is a shorter hairstyle. It's kind of like a little bit of a bob. I'm a sucker for hairstyles like this. I download so many custom content ones, and I feel like they're really flattering. Last but not least, we have this one, which I showed you guys earlier. Again, it looks amazing on females, but I think it looks even better on the males. So a nice little selection there. And I think for the sake of this video, I'm gonna make Amiko blonde, because I like it. I like it a lot. All right, cool. So moving on to some really fun accessories. We have the Plum Bob earrings that were retailing for like 220 real US dollars on the website. Now, again, not not here to knock it, but I wasn't going to buy those, even though I really wanted them. So happy that we get them in our game for $10 plus more. And they come in a bunch of colors, which I was not expecting. The real life ones are like ombre, and these ones too. So these are really fun. I really love, again, all the different swatches, all the different colors. It makes them more wearable, in my personal opinion. So we're going to stick with the green ones just because it's traditional Sims. You know what I mean? So there isn't any new makeup, but we do have a couple top options. So very similar to the Moto jacket that you literally just saw, we have this Moto jacket. Now, actually, this might sound a little weird, but I am a high fashion enthusiast. Granted, it's a little above my pay grade, but I do have a couple designer items. And one of the items I always loved from Moschino that I never purchased was their motorcycle jacket purse. Go look it up. Literally, this is it, but in sim form, which is more mind-boggling than getting these items. Like, this is more of a trip to me. And so to be able to have something that I wanted to like relish it at one point is amazing. And I ain't talking about the hot dog. So I'm pretty excited for this one. I love the way that this looks. They knocked it out of the park. Moschino has some of the most unique pieces I have ever seen. And their motorcycle jacket purse is definitely one of them. I know Trisha Paytas had it, so just, you know, just throwing that out there, the more you know, right? So I'm pretty sure I ran through like some of the swatches. We also have the basic graphic tee, which is kind of cool. Love how long it is. That's really nice. Definitely could see my Sims like sleeping in this, but probably wouldn't really wear it out. We have another girl version of the bomber jacket, which I find really interesting. Not as many swatches, which is slightly confusing because, again, like, why not, you know? The other, for the males, we had a lot of colors, but for the females, we only get two. But then again, we only got two swatches for the male motorcycle jacket. Is a little weird, but I do like this. I really love these items. For the females, I definitely think I am favoring these a bit more. Now, this item here is very true to Moschino. I'm not gonna lie, it is so weird. It's literally like a shirt that's supposed to look like a blazer, and I don't get it. The negative ghostwriter. Like, I appreciate what it's supposed to be, but what it is definitely not my freaking bag. Okay, so moving on to the bottoms, we have a matching skirt for our moto jacket, and you can interchange these. Really have fun. Dress it up, dress it down, whenever you want to do. Wear the pieces individually. Love these sets. Okay, these are shorts. Wasn't expecting that. Definitely thought for a fact that these would be like pants or a skirt or something. But I do like this. This is really unique. So this is a cool collab for kind of branching out and trying some new things, because these are definitely styles I could not foresee The Sims actually incorporating. Even though they've definitely branched out a lot, I feel like this definitely like pushed the envelope, and I'm living for it. I actually really like a lot of these pieces, except for that. That is not my favorite. Okay, it looks like something a payaso would wear. Anyway, I was wondering if maybe we could match these, and even though it's not super duper glorious, it doesn't look too bad. So there are the items. Now, we actually have more full bodies for the females than we do for the males. We've got this dress here. Can we just talk about how beautiful this dress is? This dress is everything. Check out the shimmer, the detail. The freaking thing is literally glistening. I love how it actually looks like she is wearing it. She is inside of it. Now, how cool would it have been to have this dress, right? Without this, CC creators, do you hear me? Because it's perfect. It's perfect for that. This is such a beautiful dress, and I really love, oh my God, I love it in the... Oh, don't even get me started. And this like beautiful like cashmere color. I don't even know if cashmere is a color, but sis, I am telling you, these dresses are beautiful. So, of course, we had to get the Sims bathing suit, which I actually really love. Oh my God. I wanted this too, but your girl is not going in a swimsuit. My plum bobs would be stretching. And to be freaking quite honest, it was very expensive too. I know one swimmer, I think Dr. Ashley, she actually had it, and she rocked it. She freaking literally, like, they should have put her all up in that Moschino trailer, because this girl, she made it look real good. Anyway, that's that. Moving on to the last dress. Ooh, okay. All right. You could have you and Bay match. I like that. So we have the cable knit plum bob. No, it's not plum bob, honey. That is a peace sign. Just sweater dress, kind of, sort of. Okay. All right. And then there's some teddy bears. We got some bears. And then we have the, whatchamacallit, just like a white one with some bears. Cool. And then there are also some Let me see here. No accessories, which is kind of a bummer. We do actually have a pair of heels. And these heels, I don't know if it's just me, but they kind of remind me a little bit of Barbie. All right, so we have arrived at our little makeshift studio, which I actually downloaded off of the gallery. And I do believe the creator's name is Makeeks. I don't know how to say that, and I'm probably saying it wrong. So I'm just going to go ahead and leave their username in the description in case you guys want to go and play around with the studio. Now, I did go and incorporate most, if not all, of the brand new items that came with the Moschino stuff pack in this build. So things may look a little bit different. I'm actually going to go and show you guys what those items are before we jump in to the gameplay. So over here, I made really good use of one particular room that literally had all of these objects. One of my favorite things has got to be this new neon sign. I don't know what it is, what it means, but honestly, I think it'd be so cool for so many different locations, like rooms, living rooms, apartments, all sorts of fun things. Now, we also got a really cool little like pedestal. It's kind of like a gem. It has like facets on it. I really liked that. We also got some brand new picture frames, and I do believe these guys right here are digital frames, meaning you can actually add many assets to them and you can choose like when they rotate and all that kind of fun stuff. Here are the brand new ceiling lights that work better when you have super duper tall wall heights. We've also got a really cool little sectional number, and I think you can actually attach these items to make sectional couches. I'm not 100% sure, but I think I actually heard it from somewhere. So let me go and just really quick go into the buy catalog. We're going to go and filter out everything from the Moschino stuff pack so you can kind of see what everything looks like here. Let me see. So where's our couch at? So this is a Sit On Me Now. Sit On Me sofa offers two comfortable seats and one less comfortable seat. Keep your friends close and your enemies uncomfortable. I mean, if that's not a vibe. All right, I did hear somewhere that this could be a sectional though. I'm not sure. I'm assuming you probably could, you know, like play around with it if you wanted to attach it somehow. But I'm not seeing how exactly that would work. I mean, yeah, actually, you know what? That doesn't look half bad. They've even included a brand new end table that features a glass component on top and then a matching coffee table, which I absolutely freaking love. For decor items, we got some really fun magazines. You can change up the colors on those. We even got this really nifty bookshelf that Jen does not know how to place because half of it's going through the freaking window. But I also love how like there are little slots and stuff where I'm assuming you could easily put something if you wanted to. I mean, of course, we could go and test that theory, and that theory has been proven true. So this is going to be fun for a lot of builders and people who like to clutter things up and make things look lived in. Really loved that. Now, I feel like I might be, I feel like I'm forgetting something. So we got these brand new, like, sliding glass doors that have, this really like prominent square detail on them. I really loved those a lot. We also got this signage, which would be cool to like, you know, adorn in your studio, and it can mean literally whatever you want it to mean. Comes in a bunch of swatches there. Like I said, I may not be going through all the swatches, but ooh, we've got, what is this? I forgot what it's called, like houndstooth or something. These come in some really funky prints. I actually love this is really cool. Okay, these are super fun, and you can like offset them too and switch them up. So say maybe one has houndstooth and the other one's just a black. These are really customizable. I love that. Okay, cool. All right, so I'm gonna put them back to whatever it was. Also, this rug is brand new. It's a really large surface rug, which I can appreciate because I feel like we just can never have enough rugs. So I'm pretty positive that covers everything for the downstairs. So moving into the actual studio itself, we've got so many amazing things. We've got this backdrop here, which only changes when you go in to buy. So like if you were to play in game and you wanted to change the color of the backdrop, you would have to like manually do it. You can't do it while you're playing in game, which is kind of annoying, but I just wanted to give you guys a heads up. So there's some fun patterns. You got some two-tone options, some solids, whatever. This is great for when you're actually taking like pictures for like thumbnails and stuff like that. I use in-game thumbnails sometimes for my actual like video thumbnails. Anyway, that's a whole separate video. And that's like why this pack appeals so much to me, is because the possibilities, y'all, are endless. So there is this thing, very similar to the teleporter gizmo that we have when you want to take pictures of your Sims. It's literally literally that. So what you'll do is you like, it's a marker. So you could put like one here, you could go and put like another marker here, and then you could even go and put like one back here. So essentially you would have like three Sims in this picture. And then you go over and you can hire a fashion subject, you can ask to pose, you can wait for the photographer, all sorts of fun things. So basically, these are, like I said, the teleporter mod, but not a mod anymore. I really liked that. Anyway, those are the markers. You can get them in buy mode. What else do I have to share with you? We'll dive into those things more when we actually get to the gameplay portion, but right now I just want to show you guys the items that you can build and decorate with. So we have this really cool painting, and I like it because it's like essentially four paintings in one that created the silhouette of a man. And then over here you can do white, you can also do some more, I don't really know, like abstract type of artwork if you wanted. A couple different options there, which I think is really fun. We have this amazing freaking coffee table. What is this? I will never know. I love this so much. It's like a musician's case or something. I love that there's badges. You got solids, you got red, you've got this really interesting color that I haven't seen done before. It's kind of like this coffee brown. It's like a mocha, but not really. It's more of like the burnt sienna side if you want to get like all Crayola. And then pink too, which is cool. So I loved that. And then this camera here isn't functional, but it is like a little decor item, and it looks like it's like a lens. No, it is a full-on camera. But this stuff pack does include a brand new ClickShot P10 mirrorless camera for 2,300 simoleons. It is a locked object, so your Sims will have to max out the freelancer career as a freelance photographer for their first time to be able to actually purchase this item. I'm not 100% sure if you will get it for free once you max it out. That'd be a very nice gift, but if you want, you can always like bypass this and use some cheats to get your hands on it. So I do have that on over here, this tripod. We also have, I don't know what this is some sort of like amp, I guess, like, oh god, what am I doing? It's a sort of amp stack. And then we have these two brand new lights. One of them's like a floodlight, and then this guy is a just regular studio light. I'm not very familiar like with the terminology of these lights are, but you can do so much with these. And again, perfect for when you're taking in-game photos of any kind. These will be so useful. Seriously, I'm so excited for these. Now, we actually have these digital backdrops that do some pretty amazing things. You can actually use them solo dolo, or you can even create an entire set backdrop off of these. They also have their very own gameplay capabilities, which I'll show you guys in just a second, but I thought those were really freaking cool too. I'm super excited that they included those. We have a couple little clothing racks just to, you know, zhoosh up the place. This seems like it's a bunch of like camera equipment. We've got a little roster, some cases for your equipment, some tripods, and I have no idea what this is, like a white balancing thing, and this bad boy, which is a frosted glass room divider, which, you know, is very fancy. I couldn't find a place for it, so I decided just to go and stick it there. So this is a brand new mirror, which kind of looks like one of the little chat things, you know, when the Sims are like having conversations. I thought that was pretty cool. Comes in a bunch of fun 90s colors. They've also included an entire set of these windows, which you can incorporate in so many different sequences. You can use the end caps here to create like a half circle type of a thing, or you could even throw in some of these open windows. Now, the only discrepancy I have are these counter height little loft windows. I think they're sweet. I like them a lot. I love the different, you know, height variants, obviously, but the only thing is we only get the opened version of this. It would have been pretty sweet to see it closed very much like this one. Otherwise, it's kind of like, I don't know, you know, I think I would have used maybe the closed one more often than I would the open one, especially because like I have seasons and stuff. But other than that, those are pretty cool, and I know a lot of you guys have been super excited for those. Now, we did receive two additional wallpapers. We have this bad boy here, which would be so cool as like a pop of color, a wall mural. And then we've got the, I think this is literally called like high fashion abstract or high abstract triangle, something along those lines. It's a very unique wallpaper. I think it'd be perfect for a museum, to be completely honest. All right, so let's go and dive in to some of the gameplay. So we've already got our floor marker set up, our backdrop. Like I said earlier, you can't change this unless you go into buy mode. You can, however, change and customize these digital ones, which is so amazing. But the one thing that I wanted to tell you about this tripod, because it was kind of confusing for me at first, is that in order to take pictures with the camera that is attached, you need to click the tripod. And this tripod can be put in your inventory, so it's completely portable. And the cool thing about this bad boy is you can actually take a picture of a sim with their pet, or take a picture of a sim carrying ... I don't know what that means. It's very mysterious, but I know that you can take pictures with like toddlers now, your cats, that type of a thing. Things that we couldn't do before, which I find so refreshing, especially with the brand new like picture frame and stuff. I feel like this is really going to give our Sims more life in a weird way. So in order to take a picture of a Sim that is on the mark, you're gonna need to have your Sim come on over, baby. No, I'm just fine. We ain't doing that here. Not today, sis. And take a picture of a Sim on subject mark. Now, because if you don't, they'll start wandering off, you know, like Peter Pan, and that's cool and all. I'm down for independence, but it can get very frustrating. Right now he's talking about flies. You know what? Like, okay. And now, of course, the welcome wagon is here. All right, so here we have Christian posing for the camera. So as you guys can see, we've got these little emojis here, and now we can control our Sims' emotions while they're posing for the frame. So I want Christian to go and be a little bit flirty, so let's go and change up his pose a little bit. Ooh, okay, I see you. But maybe I didn't like this dead-on shot, nor did I like how close I was. You can actually back it up a little bit. You can, of course, change your sizes. These are all things that we were able to do before. We can even come over here and like add a filter if we really wanted to and be all artsy fartsy. But the coolest thing, the best thing ever, is that we can use our arrow keys. And ooh, girl, I just did not. Oh yes, you can now free rotate. I am so excited for this for so many freaking reasons, because now I can get the angle that I've always freaking wanted, and I can take more than just 5 photos, you guys. We can now rack up to 10 photos when using the tripod. How exciting is that? So say I want to take a couple from this angle. We want to rotate it a little bit, you know, get Christian's good side. We can go ahead and hit it like that. And I can actually switch it up too. So I'll say I'm done with that pose. We wanted him to be a little bit goofy, you know. We'll take a big one of these. We'll even go ahead and, you know, rotate it or whatever, so we can get a little bit of his fit. And basically, you get the drill. So the cool thing about these is, like, I think there's like 3 poses per each category, so it kind of keeps things interesting. And I'm really curious to know if maybe CC creators will be able to, like, you know, floss on this a little bit and even add more variety. But yeah, now that we have a couple pictures of Christian, those will be in, I think, Miko's inventory. And I will tell you right now, for whatever reason, okay, I'm trying really hard to be able to, like, put these images in this frame, but it's not working. And I think it's because I have cheats on. It actually turns out that this glitch is due to an incompatibility issue with the photo frame mod. So if you have that mod in your game, remove it immediately. But there is a way around it. So the way around it, if you have this problem for whatever reason, is you just actually drag your photo that you would like to use on the wall. You can just add your frame. Cool thing about the free patch update, guys, is that now we have more options when it comes to our frame. We can do black, yellow, let's do yellow. We can go and do some other colors as well. We can now rotate the photo, so we can make it like landscape or vertical, whatever the situation is, which is kind of fun. Portrait, landscape, I guess is the correct terminology. And then if we really, really were feeling frisky, you can now drag this bad boy straight off the wall, plop it on to any surface, and oh, are you ready? Boom! That's right. We now have a tabletop photo frames. What a freaking game changer. I'm so excited. All right, so going back to what I was saying earlier about how you can fix this, you will need to make your frame black. I mean, again, this may not happen to you, and just slide it right behind it and it's fine. It still looks great. To get your pictures into this digital photo frame, you can just drag and drop. This one works just fine, and it actually changes the way that my Sims picture looks. I have a pair of Christian sneaks, so we'll toss that in. And then over here, we can manage our inventory. And I do believe, I want to say, like the landscape digital frames, they will have their own inventory, and then the portrait ones will have their own as well, so they'll be completely separate. You can throw a landscape and a portrait. It's just going to make the orientation look a little bit weird, so heads up there. We can adjust the speed. So say we wanted the photo frame to switch out every 24 hours, 12 hours, whatever your heart desires, but for the moment, we do have it at 1 hour. Granted, I don't really have like a lot of photos to share with you, so don't expect much. But yeah, here are some of the photos we took with the tripod. I am actually super duper impressed. So we played around with that. The next thing obviously to do is to play around with this. We'll play around with these probably a little bit more, maybe later. But to set the backdrop, all we need to do is just click on it, and then we can choose from so many. We can choose from red carpet. We've got cityscape, which is pretty freaking cool. I do believe like that these move too. Oh my God. Okay. So, oh, that is so cool. Seeing stars. Woo! My goodness. Bigger on the inside. So I think all of these are actually animated. Even this one seems to move. And what's even more freaking spectacular, which I told you guys earlier, is if you wanted to like combine a scene, I think you can do this. And then all you would need to do next, sorry that it's like in the stairs, all you would need to do next is just update the other one, and they will move simultaneously. Isn't that the coolest thing ever? I love that so much. We've got overcast. There are so many here. I'm not going to go through all of them, but I thought that was pretty freaking cool. I really, really loved that feature. And I think these are totally movable too, even when you're not like in build mode, which is amazing. That is so useful. So I really feel like Amico personally, see, I forgot I was in live. I think Amico personally has a knack for creativity, right? And I also cheated up her photography skill to level, gosh, what, 10? We're going to cancel out of the welcome wagon for a hot second. I wanted to actually show you what it looks like for Sims to take their camera off the tripod. It is so stinking cool. So watch Amico do this. There she goes. And then voila, you could actually change cameras if you really wanted to. And there's like a whole inventory and everything. So we're gonna have Amico join the brand new career. Granted, I'm not gonna be able to like, you know, do this to the highest power, but we are going to be able to look at it a little bit, which is super duper freaking fun. We're gonna go down to the freelancer career, and I know it's like kind of confusing because you would expect it to have its own specific menu, but it's not. It's all gonna be categorized under the freelancer career because it literally is just that. And here you will now see fashion photographer. Tomorrow's style represents and gets you the fashion shoots you need. Sure, you might get stuck with a department store catalog, but work hard and you just might shoot the next high fashion collection worn by certain celebrities at the Starlight Allocades. Hire photo subjects, select the clothes, select the subjects in the appropriate poses, and capture the magic. Build a home photo studio or take your camera and a tripod on location to get the best shots. Don't forget to self-promote by uploading your photos to Fashion Simsgram. Okay, this honestly has Jasper written all freaking over it, and I love that this could easily tie in to, you know, I don't know, get famous, maybe possibly if you have the pack, I don't know, let me know in the comments down below. But I think this would be really cool for that. Like, I think this would be amazing for that, actually. So we are going to select a trade, which I'm pretty sure that I just did. Maybe I got too excited and clicked out of it because I literally could not breathe. Yeah, that's exactly what freaking happened. Okay, so now we're gonna check for some gigs, and oh my goodness gracious, we actually have quite a few. And that is probably because our photography skill is so high, but Starting off, you might be a little more limited to the lower categories here, such as casual and stylish. There's athletic wear for the couch potato. Oh my God, I'm slightly inclined to choose this one. We also have genius, professor, outdoor wear study. Oh my God, there are so many different ones. Finding the style, work with a style influencer to create the perfect photo capturing fresh and fun fashions from next season's line. You will have creative freedom to choose your own clothing and photo subjects. Okay, cool. So, you know what? I definitely feel like this gig is for me. It'll give us 1,000 simoleons. We need to have it in by Thursday at 9 a.m. And we just at least need to have level 5 of the photography skill, which we have level 10. So it says chat with style influencer. Click on the computer and select the chat with style influencer interaction under the freelance pie menu. All right, so we are going to chat with style influencer. Now that we've built up that relationship, he is now a part of our relationships, and he is a notable newcomer as well. So he is kind of like famous, but also not really. He says, I can't wait to see photos of today's trending style. So the next thing Amiko needs to do is she actually needs to take a photo of Sims in an everyday outfit, or in everyday wear attire. What I think we're going to have her do is we are going to have her go and hire a fashion subject for 100 simoleons. Oh my God, it's freaking Lancey. What the heck is going on? First it's Iggy, now it's Lancey Landgrab. But honestly, I'm not even mad. This chick seriously needs a freaking makeover. The few new interactions that we can complete are to ask to change outfit, discuss fashion blogging, discuss fashion trends. We can also show off photos if we had some photos in our inventory, and we can plan outfits for a fashion subject. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to have Amiko over here, who's feeling a little insecure, okay, in her talents. We're going to have her go and plan outfits for today's photo shoot. She went to the bathroom. I'm not really sure why she did, but hopefully she'll come back. I feel bad. Influencer style. Speaking with famous influencers is motivating and inspiring. Let's go and fix Miss Nancy up. Now, I could easily go and plan an entire outfit for her. The only thing that we have control over is basically just the... Well, it seems like everything. Like, I could even change her physique too, but that is because I probably have cheats on. But we can use anything. Like, we could go freaking balls to the wall. We could go and change her hair. We can give her some freaking eyebrows if we really were feeling a little bit daring. Maybe these ones, actually. To be honest, these blonde brows have got to go. I'm not really worried too much on, like, her makeup and stuff. But, you know, if I really wanted to, like, slap on, you know, a couple new accessories, give her a little bit of an upgrade. I don't think she would be that mad at it. So let's give her some lipstick too. Kind of thinking maybe going with this really pretty plum color. I like the earrings. Actually, I would love if we used the brand new Moschino earrings that we got actually. So let's go and filter those out. We're going to give those ones an upgrade. Let's do gold, okay? Because Nancy is a very classy lady, and already I think Amiko is doing amazing. So I want to give her maybe one of the new dresses that we got. And of course, you can switch it up. You could easily go ahead and play around a little bit, use some custom content, anything that your heart desires. It is completely up to you. Ooh, I love this dress on her. Okay, all right, so let me go and see what shoes we should use. I don't know if the heels that came with this pack would be appropriate. What do you guys think? I don't know. We could try the black ones. I mean, they're not that bad. And the whole outfit, actually, it looks pretty decent. Granted, I think I would actually go with the black plum bobs for this. And maybe switch out the lips for something a little more nude. Yes. Okay, so that to me looks a little bit better. Granted, it's not my best work, but it's something is definitely better than nothing. And she went from a solid like 2 and a freaking animal cracker to at least a 5.0 and a plunger. I mean, it's better. And she actually looks really freaking good. She looks really good. I take that back. She looks amazing, actually. So you're gonna ask Nancy to go ahead and start posing for the camera, and then we will take a picture of her. Let me see. Take picture of Sim on subject mark. Perfect. All right. Awesome. So hopefully she'll stand still and we won't have any problems here. We're going to use the white backdrop. I actually feel like that is very, I don't know, it's very clean looking and I'm liking this. Oh my goodness. Okay. So I want Nancy because she is kind of a flirtatious sim, or at least, you know, a sim with a lot of allure. We're gonna do full body shot, actually. I'm not really liking how this is fisheye, and also there's like a really weird, do you guys see that? Like a really weird shadow happening here. Maybe I won't do it, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, but let me go and get a good angle. Let's do, ooh, I love how that just changes the way that the picture looks, right? It kind of gives it a little more depth. So I'm going to take a couple of Nancy just to be in, you know, super duper, you know, relaxed, nothing too crazy. And then we'll try the romantic interactions, or not the interactions, the romantic poses. And I really like this one too. I actually feel like Nancy looks really pretty, to be honest. All right, so then we'll take a couple of those. And what else do we have? Fashion. All right, I want to see. Oh my God. Okay, I feel like I've seen this pose before, but is there anything else? Ooh, I don't like this one. Oh my God, I hate it. She looks like she's sucking on a Sour Patch. Oh, okay, now she looks like she just waffed Montemar's Kulo. All right, you know what? I'm going to go and take this one, especially with her cocktail ring. Like, it's kind of a vibe. I like it. All right, you know what? We'll finish those off with those few poses there, and let's see if anything interesting happened. So apparently by taking all those photos, we became really good friends with her. And oh my God, okay, so we didn't need to do 5 different sims, we just needed to take 5 photographs, and that is all that was needed to be done. Oh my goodness gracious, I actually really like the fact that she became friends with Nancy Landgrab. Or Lancy Landgrab, really. I mean, she might have a whole new brand. I love how Christian's congratulating her for her first gig. And the fact that a freaking Landgrab entrusted us with something so freaking huge. I kind of want to step it up. I want to do like one more gig, but I want it to be like the creme de la creme. And I also want to use this digital photo frame thing. I was also thinking of maybe playing around a little bit with posing with a dog or a cat or something, but a part of me also wants to like leave that to you guys. Like, I'm intentionally leaving it out so you have something to discover. Not to mention, I bet so many people are going to be showcasing that too as well, but I'm not really sure yet. So we need to go and call Izzy and invite him over. Or actually, there's a new interaction, meet with style influencer, so that way we can hopefully get paid for the gig. I like this. Now I am curious. I really want to know if it would be possible to, like, if you have get to work, maybe open up your own studio so it feels a little more official and sell like your portraits and stuff, and maybe even have like mannequins of the clothing, you know, the clothing that you've styled or whatever the situation might be. I think that'd be a really cool idea. So I feel like you could do a lot with this if you had the other packs. I love how he's checking himself out. He is truly Izzy Fabulous. Once you meet up with Iggy, your job doesn't stop there. You have about 6 hours or so to accomplish all of these tasks. So what we need to do is we need to come over here and we need to basically chat this kid up. We need to discuss fashion blogging. We need to entertain Iggy by telling him an engaging story, any type of story actually. Take a photo of a style influencer. I'm wondering if we took a selfie. Maybe would that count? All that for freaking nothing. Oh my goodness gracious. I thought I could cheat the system, but you know what? Izzy isn't having that. Izzy isn't having that. So we're gonna go and have him pose. Okay, we're gonna take a couple pictures of him. Take picture of Izzy Fabulous. And this is definitely a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. Oh my God. All right, so we're gonna have him do a fabulous pose. How about that? Let's actually play around with the excited poses here, which I kind of like, but not really. He's not super photogenic, but this one's actually quite nice. So we'll go with this one, and I think I'm going to rotate it a little bit because this is probably one of my new favorite features. It looks like he's literally breaking out of jail right now. Like, somebody show me the handcuffs. Next, we are going to, let me see here, tell him a story. Let's do engaging story, and now I have to figure out how exactly I show him the photos, because I don't know how to do that. It doesn't even tell me. So show off photos requires Miko to have at least one photo in her inventory, and we have lots of photos in our inventory. We're gonna go and exit out of the event, and I hope that it. Yeah, no, it did. Okay, so that actually counted towards our gig, right? And we earned 1,200 simoleons. So I do believe that's exactly what we were supposed to earn. And immediately Izzy goes away. Working with such a talented style influencer and fashion photographer has made this one of the most successful social media postings of all time. Fantastic work, Miko. Now it is about like 10 freaking PM, so we should probably call it a night, but I really want to attempt one more gig. Now, there are so many to choose from, and I could probably sit here for the next 5 hours playing with them all, but like I said, I wanted to give you guys a little taste, just a little tiny nip of what this pack has to offer. So we did do something relatively, you know, high profile. I mean, it was like level 5 photography skill. We got $1,200. Now, I'm kind of thinking maybe we should do let me see, Jazzed for Jammies spring catalog. Now, we didn't really get anything for jammies, so that kind of stinks, but I wanted to do something with the digital backdrop. I thought that would be kind of fun real quick. So maybe what we could do is, wait, hold on, wet or dry swimwear. Actually, you know what, I think this one seems really fun. You've been asked to put together a glamour shot of Sims in swimwear. The client requests that it features Sims who look good lounging by the pool. Now I feel really bad because this entire time we have not used our best friend Christian for any of these gigs, and I'm not gonna lie, like, I'm pretty sure he looks phenom in a swimsuit. So we'll snag this one here, and let's go and see what it is that we need to do. So we need to take a photo of a group of Sims, a group of 3 Sims. Oh my god, we need to get the photo approved and post to the fashion Instagram. So they're all different. Not every time do you necessarily need to meet with Iggy, right? Okay, cool. So I already have Christian. I'm definitely going to use him in this photo op, and now all I need to do is set up the stage for 3 Sims. So what we'll do is we'll remove this backdrop, which is like 80 bucks. Super easy, cheap to get started. We're gonna go and start moving in these big pieces here, and hopefully I'll have enough room for everybody. I'm gonna actually have to move the coffee table. The goal is to get everything as seamless as possible. So we're gonna do one Sim there, okay? We'll do another Sim behind, and then one more over there. I'm really curious, you guys, to see how this thing is going to make them all pose, because there's 3 different Sims, but I don't know. I guess we'll have to find out. So let's set the backdrop to overcast. Let me see. Vertical lights, sunlit forest. I mean, this is kind of an interesting backdrop for a bathing shoot, but that's cool. Or maybe we should do cityscape. Actually, that'd be kind of fun too. So let's do sunlit forest for everything, or cotton candy. I feel like that would be kind of cool too, but I want ew, no, I don't like that rainbow one. I thought it was gonna be like rainbow. Seeing stars, that one isn't too bad. Now I definitely feel like out of all of them, sunlit forest is probably gonna be my bag. All right, so let me try to like center this camera a little bit more. So we've got Christian, which he's totally fine, but we need to hire 2 more subjects. The problem is we don't need males. We can have any Sim. So we're gonna hire 2 more subjects. I could actually use Nancy, and this is, oh my god, that's making me dizzy. Oh my god. Oh no, I'm my close up. Oh, Mr. Dennis. Oh dear God. You know what? We're gonna run with this. We are going to run with it. We are gonna ask him to change his outfit really quick. Where is my other model? Hello. Oh my gosh, these people are so finicky. Christian, it needs to come downstairs. This is really making me dizzy. That is crazy. The motion is making me like feel like anybody else, or is it just me? I don't know. I might be the weird one here, but like, who knew? All right, let's try this again. Okay, so we want him to go into his swimwear. Now, Mr. Dennis, no. We need something a little more revealing, okay? Just a little bit. Don't be afraid, Dennis. Don't be afraid. Okay. We're gonna plan some outfits. What we're gonna do is we are just gonna get our boys all in Speedos. That's exactly what is going to happen here. All right, so I got 2 out of 3 down, and what I really like is when you tell the Sims to like stay and wait for the photographer, they actually listen. It's way easier than having to like catch everybody. And the very last Sim we got is this fellow over here. His name is Gavin Richards. Okay, cool. So as you guys can see, we are definitely going for that sim watch type of theme. Let me go and have, let me see if we can, you know what? Okay, I'm gonna have him change his outfit too, and you can interact with them. I'm not sure if you can like make them change outfits while they're standing there, but they will not move unless instructed otherwise, at least from my personal experience, which is so helpful. All right, so we're gonna have Gavin go into this. Obviously we want him to match everybody else, so we are going to give him the last and final Speedo on our rack, and it's actually really fun. Like, I am having a good time making everybody kind of be my little puppet and, you know, staging the scene. If you love doing like photography type of things in the game, you will absolutely love this. Like, this is going to be so much fun for you. I'm really enjoying it so far. Like, I love all of the objects and stuff. Like, I think that alone is definitely worth $9, but throw in this career, which seems pretty immersive. I do think it's a level, I want to say, I don't know, maybe 10, maybe not, probably like a 5. Either way, it feels like there's a lot of gameplay here. So now that we've got everybody ready to go, we are going to, let me see, take picture of Sim on subject mark. I'm kind of curious to see. Okay, take pictures of. All right, you know, I'm so nervous. I'm having a lot of fun, but I'm really nervous that I'm gonna screw this up. Okay, cool. So take picture of Sim on subject mark, and you can collect all 3 of your Sims. I'm not sure if there's a limit to how many, maybe not even. So you could take like group photos and stuff. Like, could you imagine your own family portraits? That would be absolutely incredible. So unfortunately, oh my, sorry, my husband probably just heard me laughing. Oh my god, unfortunately, Dennis, he's a little confused as to where he should be looking. But you know what? That's totally A-okay. These boys look absolutely freaking amazing. Christian and Gavin, I kind of ship it. I ship it big time. So, you know, we gotta blow this up, sis. I am living. Oh my god, this looks so good. Okay, I'm gonna take a couple of just the standard, I'm a little flustered, standard portrait type of style, and then I'll tell these boys be a little bit flirty. Ooh, okay, maybe not that one. I like how it's actually getting randomized. That's kind of cool. So maybe flirty wouldn't be the vibe. How about fashion? Okay, yeah, I see that smolder. I probably could have gotten Dennis like a little bit closer actually to the boys, but that's my bad. Okay, cool. And you know what, if I wanted to, oh yeah, I think I can rotate here too as well. Oh my goodness gracious, this is seriously so cool. Okay, so let's take a couple there, and just because I want to do what the ad had asked me to do, I'm going to do the long like landscape, and then I'm gonna try, oh that's actually really good. I'm gonna get it like that. We're very inclusive here at Emiko Model Studios. You feel me? All right. I think this is definitely the breadwinner. I feel like this is exactly what the client asked for. And to be honest, I really like it. I'm kind of proud, actually. Don't necessarily love the background, but you know what? I think it's gonna work. And I like how both of them are looking at each other like, what the hell did we sign up for? Oh my god. Okay, cool. So the next thing that Emiko needs to do is she needs to get this photo approved. I'm feeling a little nervous because that was a lot of work to be essentially let down. But we're going to go and select the image with the 3 boys here. Submit a photo for client's approval. Cross your fingers. Okay, so I had Emiko go and send her photos off to approval, and I am so excited to say that the client has approved our photos. What a fantastic shot. Approved photos arrive in the mail in the next 1 or 2 days. So check your mailbox and then post the photo online to the fashion Simstagram. So when you are actually submitting your photos and they disappear from your inventory, don't have a little mini heart attack like your girl did and think, oh my God, you totally jacked things up, because that is literally your freaking mantra. But okay, it's completely normal. In fact, your sim will get like a little moodlet saying how excited they are about sending their photos off to get approved. And then when it actually comes back, your sim will get a new moodlet saying, pleasing a client fills me with professional pride. So it looks like Emiko is going to have to send her models, okay, on their very way. And we're going to have to wait a day or two until we get them back so that we can put them on the interwebs. So it is literally the next afternoon, and Emiko received all of her images in the mail. And that was a lot faster than I thought it was going to be honest. I literally thought we were going to be waiting a day or two. So now it is time, my friends, to go and, oh my goodness gracious, I got my photos back. Why aren't you letting me go and post them to the fashion Simstagram? You guys saw that, right, though? Like, it's still saying approved photos need to be in the Sims inventory to be able to be posted, but they're literally, like, sitting right there. But it does work when on the counter. So hopefully this will be the very last task that Emiko needs to do. Okay, so I was able to figure it out and Emiko completed the gig. She ended up earning 1,530 simoleons, and it says, the swimwear fashionista Seaside Samantha saw Emiko Mori's photo and praised Emiko Mori's fashion choices on her blog, vlog, and Simstagram. Wow! Hey, what's up, Emiko? I noticed your name has been all the buzz lately. How do you feel about catching up? I mean, we were always friends before you made it big, right? Oh my God, look at freaking Nancy Landgrab brown nosing our Emiko Mori. But before I wrap up this video, I just want to give you guys my overall thoughts on the Sims 4 Moschino stuff pack. So originally, when I heard about this stuff pack, like many, I definitely was not a fan, thought it was completely unnecessary, and I was worried it was going to be like my first pet stuff to It was really cool just like seeing an entire different side of The Sims than I am normally used to seeing. You know, being really immersive in the careers is fun for a lot of people, and being able to like set the stage and then have these objects to use on a daily basis, whether it be for my own families or my Let's Plays, even just like my assets such as like thumbnails and stuff like that. I feel like for $9.99, just the objects alone are worth the money. Now, the only thing I will say that I was disappointed in is definitely the lack of swatches. And the lack of swatches inconsistency-wise, meaning I felt like some had a lot of swatches, some didn't, and then where they didn't, they could have, and that part was just really confusing to me. But other than that, I really like it. I think it's really fun, and I could see myself, especially if you have Get Famous and get to work, I could see myself building an entire studio and creating like a career out of it. Like, with your imagination and those packs, you could do so much. So if you guys were to ask me to rate this pack 0 to 10, 0 being the lowest and 10 being the highest, I would definitely give this a solid 7.5. There are some things that I wish were a little bit different, which I've already talked about, but overall, I think this is a pretty solid stuff pack for $9.99. So, if you guys are interested in picking this bad boy up, I do believe it will be released on Origin mañana. I'm not exactly sure what the time frame is, but if I find out those credentials, I'll leave them in the description. I am really curious to know what you guys think about this pack. What would you have liked seen added? What would you like maybe to have been different? Just your overall thoughts and theories. And of course, be constructive with your criticisms and be friendly. Ultimately, I don't want y'all having a full on like turf war in the comments. It ain't about that. Okay. It's pixels, guys. It's just freaking pixels. Okay. So with that said, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video here. I hope that you all enjoyed. And if you did, you know what to do, boo. Don't forget to go ahead and comment, rate, and subscribe. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below, where the sun does not shine, and I will see you all next time. Bye, guys. Just watch me. I got your wrapped around my finger.